we're making crock pot laulau. First, I'm going to do a little bit of preparation before we start to prep. I went outside into the yard and I got 4 tea leaves, and we're going, these have been cleaned and ribbed. Those of you on the mainland, if you are going to want to try this and do not have access to tea leaves, the closest thing I could think of that you could use that can keep in the moisture like what we need is banana leaves. If not, then sorry, this is more a local dish with slim possibility of you being able to find the luau leaf also. You could probably use spinach. Anyway, 4 tea leaves to line your crock pot on the bottoms and on the sides with the shiny part up. If you can see, one side is a little shinier and the other side is a little dull. Now we're done with that part. I'm gonna go cut my pieces of pork. You can use, it calls for 6 pounds of boneless pork butt or country style ribs. I have the country style ribs, so I'm gonna get to cutting. Cut them into 1.5 inch cubes. I'll be right back. All right, so I have my pork cut up, and we're gonna add to this about 3 tablespoons of Hawaiian salt to taste, and 3 tablespoons of shoyu. Now this is interesting because I have never had, well, I've never had crock pot laulau, but I've never had shoyu as a flavoring for this. Usually there is salt fish, and this one interestingly doesn't call for salt fish. So I'm wondering if this isn't going to take the place of that flavor. Then, the other ingredient that you all probably won't be able to get a hold of is taro leaves. These are the leaves to the root of the taro, and we call it luau leaf. And this is just the leaf. This is the stem. You could also use the stem. If you're going to use the stem, you're going to have to cut it, you know, have to peel the stems off. But by doing that, you stain your hands and anything you touch brown. So I'm gonna skip using the stems, which is a waste, and my dad would probably wanna smack me, but dad's not here. The other thing that this thing, this recipe says is to put, line half of these on the bottom of the crock pot, and then we're putting the pork, and then line the other half. But I really, really wanted to try to get it to be at least somewhat close to being a laulau. So I'm going to just go ahead and make it as if it were a laulau. Now, the thing with the pork here, you have to have some kind of fat on the meat, because if not, your laulau is going to be very, very dry. And then you just roll this up, and if you were making a traditional laulau, you would then wrap this up in a tea leaf like this, and then we would be steaming it. But this is not the regular way, so I'm going to just lay these beautiful packets down into the bottom. I think I counted 14 leaves, so I'll be able to get 14 laulau out of this. And then that's if I cut enough meat. I'm not sure. I just cut half the packet because it's just 2 of us. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to continue doing that and laying it into my crock pot, and I'll be back. We'll finish this up. I just realized that I don't think I showed how I wrapped it on here. I put 2 leaves on top of one another. Some people put a lot more. I prefer a lot of leaf with my laulau. I put it right in the heart, in the center of the heart. See, the luau leaf is shaped as a heart. Put it right in the middle, and then you just wrap it up like you would any sort of bundle of food. Okay, and then I put the last of them in there. Let's move you over here I got a lot going on. Let me make sure the hands are clean. Okay, so I went ahead and I added another layer of tea leaves because the first set got pushed down. But we are going to add in another layer of leaves. So that pretty much covers it. Looks like I only need to have one more leaf on the top here. Maybe two. Just want to cut them down to size. And we just basically want to keep the moisture inside as much as possible. And since I had to go out and get more leaves. Oh, and the shiny side facing down this time instead of up, okay? I passed by my banana tree, and as you can see, the banana leaves are somewhat similar in consistency, and is something that we also use. See, the back side is also dull, the top side is shiny. It's also something that we use when we make our emu. Now we're going to get a piece of aluminum foil, and it looks like mine. Yeah, hold on, I'm gonna just use regular. Oh, baby heard her dish. Yeah, you didn't want a little pig. We're gonna cover that with the tin foil, and then we're going to put the top on. And you can put it on high for, 4 hours, or low for 8 hours. I'm going for the low. Go for the low and the slow. And so if you were gonna do the way the recipe calls for, you would layer half of your leaf on the bottom, put the pork in, then put the other half of your leaves on top, and then cover with the tea leaves. So we're gonna leave this go for 8 hours. Wow. Okay, so I'll be back to show you what it looks like. Okay, people. I have crap going on in life right now that... Anyway, I just realized I had forgotten to add in the water. It's just a quarter cup of water. But, you know, the tea leaf and stuff, all of this stuff is all water. Maybe I should use a tongs, but oh my god, it smells so good. See, it has created its own water. Whoops, I spilled some. But yeah, my head hasn't been in the game, and I don't know why I decided to record this, but I did. Life. Okay. I'm going to cover it back up, and I have another 4 hours to go, but it does smell very good so far, and now it's going to take time to reheat back up to where it was at. Alright. Okay, 8 hours later, I just turned it off. Take off the tin foil. And I shall use, let's see, I will use a piece of paper or towel to put these away. And I want to show you what the laulaus look like. Alrighty. Oh, that looks beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. There's a little laulau pie. That's awesome. Awesome, awesome indeed. Smells wonderful. There you go, crock pot laulau. Enjoy. All right, people, I'm sure some of you are going to ask, this is a kalua pig. I have a recipe up for crock pot kalua pig. The laulau. Oh, it is so good. You know, It didn't even, I was thinking maybe it needed a little bit of smoke flavoring to it. It doesn't. That would ruin it, I think. Very, 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 very good. And then there's my poi. There you go. Crock pot laulau. Enjoy, because I am nanny nanny boo boo. Another thing, because I'm sure people are going to ask, is does it taste like spinach? The answer is no. What does it taste like? I can't even tell you what it's compared to. It's awesomeness, really. The taro, look up, Google taro, T-A-R-O, and read about the awesomeness that poi is, P-O-I, all right? There you go.